A more fundamental way to characterize a random walk is by its probability distribution, namely, the probability that a random walk is at position x at time t. We will call this fundamental probability distribution Pxt. What I want to do now is calculate this distribution for discrete space, discrete time, one-dimensional random walk. So let's imagine a random walk that lives in one dimension with discrete sites, like this. And so here is position x minus 2, x minus 1, x plus 1, x plus 2. And let's suppose that a random walk hops to nearest neighbors equiprobably to the left and to the right. So from x, one hops with probability 1/2 to the right and probability 1/2 to the left. And similarly, from x plus 1, you can hop to x plus 2 with a probability 1/2 or to the left with a probability 1/2, and the same for every other site of the lattice. With this picture, let me now compute the probability distribution for this random walk. And this probability distribution is calculated by means of something known as a master equation, which describes how this probability distribution evolves in time. So how can we be at position x at time t? There are only two ways this can occur. Either the random walk was at x minus 1, and it hopped to the right with a probability 1/2, and it was at x minus 1 at the previous time, so there'll be 1/2 p x minus 1, one step to the left at the previous time, and the factor 1/2 accounts for the fact that it hops to the right with probability 1/2, or the random walker was at position x plus 1 at the previous time step and hopped to the left. So this object is called the master equation, and it describes how the probability distribution evolves in time. Now it turns out a little bit simpler to, instead of calculating Pxt, to look at Prt, the probability that in time t I take r steps to the right. So here, little r is the number of steps to the right. And let me define little l as the number of steps to the left. And then r plus l, the sum of the number of steps to the right and to the left, is the total time t. And r minus l, the difference in the number of steps to the right and to the left, is equal to x. So once we compute PRT, we will then be able to reconstruct PXT. So what is PRT? So in principle, one can solve the master equation directly, but here I'm just going to argue probabilistically that I just have to count the total number of walks that take a total of r steps to the right. So the total number of walks of any size, of any orientation, is just t factorial, because I can take the steps in any order. So there's an overall factor, t factorial. However, if I want to constrain my walk to take r steps to the right, that means that of these t factorial arrangements of the steps, r of them have to be to the right, and l of them have to be to the left. So the number of distinct ways of doing this, we have to divide t factorial by r factorial, because all right steps, we can take them in any order, and it'll end up at the same place. And similarly for the number of left steps. And then we have a 1/2 to the power t, because each step occurs with probability 1/2. So this quantity is precisely the probability that a random walker takes r steps to the right in a walk of a total of t steps. But now, using this relation between r, l, and t and x, we can compute r is equal to t plus x over 2, and similarly l is equal to t minus x over 2. So therefore, we have our fundamental result that Pxt is equal to t factorial divided by t plus x over 2 factorial t minus x over 2 factorial 1/2 to the power t. Now, in this discrete form, it's actually not very convenient to do any manipulations, because it's discrete and we can't use the power of calculus. And so in general, one wants to find this probability distribution in the limit of t going to infinity. And in this long time limit, we can use Stirling's approximation to reduce the factorials to analytic functions. So let me just write Stirling's approximation. And the result is that one finds after some algebra 2 over square root of pi t e to the minus 2x squared over t. So this quantity is known as the Gaussian probability distribution, and as we're going to learn, it's a relatively universal feature of random walks. Now, I've glossed over going from the discrete to the continuum because this formulation of a discrete time, discrete space random walk, even though it's conceptually elementary, is analytically kind of clunky. And so I'm going to arrive at the Gaussian probability distribution in a more elegant fashion by treating this problem in the continuum limit. So this will be the subject of the next slide. After this lecture was completed, somebody pointed out that I made a stupid mistake in the final result. So in using Stirling's approximation to go from the factorial expression for the probability distribution to the Gaussian, the 2 doesn't belong in the numerator, it belongs in the denominator. Sorry about that.